There are a few effects in cinema that can suit moments of innocence, fantasy, and romance, as well as tension, violence, and destruction. The art of slow motion is central to film language, adding emphasis to emotions, clarity to spectacle, and much more. This is the ultimate guide to slow motion. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe and click the bell for more videos. And tell us in the comments which camera techniques you'd like for us to cover next. Please note that this video contains a bit of graphic content.
This is Sparta!
And spoilers for the following films. Now, let's get started. Slow motion refers to a cinematic moment when the speed of action appears to slow down. Traditionally, this experience of slowed time can heighten emotion or convey the sheer intensity of a scene, allowing us to see the finer details we might have missed at normal speed. To achieve slow motion, filmmakers will shoot images at a higher frame rate than the traditional 24 frames per second. When these scenes are then displayed at 24 FPS, the image will appear to move more slowly. This clip from Carefree was shot at 96 frames per second. The higher the frame rate a camera shoots at, the slower the movement can appear. This is sometimes referred to as overcranking, referencing the early cinematic methods of hand crank photography and projection. Overcranking maintains smooth motion and clarity. As we've established, slow motion can be used in a variety of settings, but it's perhaps most frequently associated with action. In action cinema, we see some of the most iconic uses of slow-mo. Whether it be in capturing explosions, or extending the duration of a shootout scene. The effect can allow filmmakers to take chaotic moments and present them with a higher level of clarity. In the famous staircase shootout scene from Brian De Palma's Untouchables, action is presented almost entirely in slow motion, with the added threat of a rolling baby carriage placed in the center of the gunfire. By slowing the carriage's descent, De Palma can maximize the tension. Extending the duration of the shootout in slow motion allows the filmmaker to interject reaction shots and moments of hesitation, culminating in suspense. Through this additional coverage, viewers can easily keep track of each character in this moment of peril. If played back in real time, the scene would feel disorienting, and the dynamic staging of our characters would likely go unnoticed.
What are you doing?
Shut up! Come on, say shut up!
Mom!
What? Oh, sorry.
Director John Woo has utilized slow motion throughout his career, creating dazzling action sequences which employ the technique to get the most out of actors' physical performances. Woo not only shoots action scenes on multiple cameras, but he also shoots at multiple frame rates. The result is dynamic scenes with action heightened by various speeds. Director Zack Snyder favors the slow motion effect for capturing epic imagery, finding moments where cinema can parallel a comic book panel. In Watchmen, Snyder rapidly shifts from moments of real-time motion to slow motion, freezing on significant moments which mimic the experience of seeing the story unfold in still images on the page. The Matrix's bullet time sequence combines images from 120 different still cameras and two film cameras not only to slow down time, but also to create a dynamic camera movement which encircles the actors. Visual effects artist John Gaeta describes the process.
The two motion picture cameras are going to be, in this particular shot, running. That's running at 150, that one's running at 120.
The Matrix also marks a shift where these slow motion shots can be used within the narrative. In Dread, slow-mo not only refers to the effect featured prominently throughout the film, but a drug central to the film's story and world. The filmmakers used Phantom Flex high-speed cameras for these sequences, which are capable of filming up to 3,000 frames per second. Inception also incorporates the effect into the narrative itself. Slow motion shots are not only used to emphasize the action, but to visualize the different rate of time between each dream. This falling vehicle was filmed with a Photosonics 4ER, a film camera that can shoot up to 1,200 frames per second, and a Phantom digital camera which can go up to 4,000 FPS. Slow motion is crucial for many action movies, but it can also be used to emphasize dramatic moments as well. The slow motion shot doesn't always require bombastic action to be an effective storytelling tool. Simple character moments can provide equally powerful moments of emphasis. Wes Anderson favors this use of the tool. A slow motion shot can provide narrative closure, like a cinematic curtain call. It can show all of our major characters together on screen to suggest reconciliation, turning the page on this chapter of their lives, or simply finding the strength to carry on. For Anderson, the slow motion shot creates a window into some of life's most substantial moments. Using the technique to highlight times where the world around us might feel like it's slowing down, or reminding us of personal memories we'd like to replay. In a film which uses voiceover, slow-mo can allow extra time for a moment of narration, without distracting viewers with too much additional on-screen information.
Where's your head, Agent Kuyan?
The voiceover, meanwhile, maintains momentum.
As we walked along the flat block marina, I was calm on the outside, but thinking all the time. So now it was to be Georgie the General, saying what we should do and what not to do, and dim as his mindless, grinning bulldog.
Similarly, slow motion can be used in concert with music, so that characters' movements can be more in sync with the emotions conjured by the soundtrack. Slow motion can also have a romantic, beautifying effect, making it a favorite for filmmakers conveying introductions and first impressions. This form of slow motion can evoke a character's gaze and desire.
I feel like I've been in a coma for about 20 years, and I'm just now waking up.
In Fight Club, Marla Singer's on-screen introduction is presented in slow motion, along with glamorous lighting and framing that aligns our gaze with that of the film's main character. The effect is seductive, suggesting something more is hiding under the surface. Sometimes slow motion can be used in a more unexpected way, creating a sense of surrealism. Filmmakers throughout the 20th century also experimented with slow motion's ability to create a surreal or dreamlike effect. This famous scene from Jean Vigo's Zero for Conduct uses feathers in the air to make the effect feel both disruptive and joyous. The French filmmaker Jean Cocteau also use slow motion to weave a fairy tale atmosphere. In Immortals, slow motion is applied to only certain elements in the frame, creating a stylized fight scene where the slow-mo exists in the fantasy world. This deceptively simple moment from David Lynch's Lost Highway manages to operate on multiple thematic and narrative levels. DP Peter Deming shot the sequence at 96 frames per second on a Mitchell camera, which wasn't a sync model, creating a flicker in the fluorescent lights. Lynch liked the effect, saying, "The dreamier and weirder you can make it, the better." The effect creates a danger and allure for our central character, who is intrigued by a dangerous adversary's romantic partner, while also hinting at something more sinister. We've seen this figure before, and the slow motion fully allows for the doppelganger motif to be made apparent. This surrealist use of slow motion can create a sense of distance between the audience and characters. In this scene from The Bling Ring, the main ensemble are presented in slow motion, ensuring that we feel the same rush of excitement they do. There is a sense that this carefree group is ultimately doomed, and that this moment is now preserved in the past tense. Both of these ideas are reinforced with the ominous sound design, which slowly devolves the music into a low drone. In Jean-Luc Godard's Every Man for Himself, sound is played at regular speed, while the image is slowed. This disorients the audience and creates a feeling of anticipation as we wait for the image to catch up to what we're hearing. Stanley Kubrick uses this technique in Full Metal Jacket. The sound is what the soldiers can hear, while the image is shot at 120 frames per second on a high-speed Mitchell camera, emphasizing the horror and helplessness the characters are feeling while their comrades die. Slow motion is a critical technique for filmmakers looking to enhance and emphasize specific actions and emotions in their work, whether it be an explosive action sequence or a simple moment between two characters. The effect allows us to experience time in a way we couldn't in any other medium, and lets filmmakers devise new, technological, and storytelling tricks in the process. For a complete breakdown of this shot from Zack Snyder's 300, watch our video linked in the description. Pulling off an effective slow motion shot can require a lot of planning. And there's no better way to start planning your next shoot than with StudioBinder's storyboard software. Click the link in the description to get started. That's all for now. Remember, until next time, take it slow.